Vanessa, aka Fontanessa, representing Inspire My Smile, and today I am out here in the lovely Different Costas Factory, and I have a special guest here, a local from rapper, MC, who goes by the name of B-Dot.
B-Dot U. Hello.
Hi. Oh, yeah. Thank you for being my guest today. So I'll be that, like, what have you been up to?
Well, I've been working behind the scenes musically, just based on the fact that I would like to have some material and some foundation for carry on. So I'm just working along with that at the moment until I'm ready, and then I'm gonna take a step forward.
Okay. How would you like describe your genre? Like, what can you just like give like a description of what you do when music, what's the message?
Okay, well, in general, musically, I do grime. Just at the base of, like, I like a fast tempo. Like, I've been brought up around the urban grime thing, so I do grime. But at the moment, as I grow and get older as a person, like, my music's now changed. So now it's become more of a concept, grime, hip-hop kind of style I have. So I like to have a message across rather than just general rhyming words, as people like to say. So yeah, I like to try and get a grime hip-hop brand out, but with a concept behind it now.
Okay. And tell us about your, because the last tune that I heard from you was it Work Hard?
Work Hard, Play Hard.
Work Hard, Play Hard. And that was a catchy tune, like. So what happened with that? Did you put out more material? Did you?
Well, what happened with that was Work Hard, Play Harder was produced by Dot Rotten, which I just...
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So I used his beat and then I sent it to him, X, Y, and Z.
Okay.
But then once I made that tune, I actually didn't put it out in terms of on radio, X, Y, and Z, because I myself wasn't confident at that time.
Okay.
That's why I did a lot of performances with it, just to see how everyone's reaction was to it, you know what I mean? So. Obviously you've heard it as a performance and you liked it and everyone else liked it. So it was just the fact of how I was going to distribute it to the audience, you know what I mean? Because I didn't have a visual idea of how to get it out there. So it's still there, like, it's going to be on the Prize Fighter DVD, which is a music event hosted by DJ Big Mikey and Ozone Media. But then from there, I'm hoping to get an actual visual properly and then get the ball rolling from there.
Okay. And I'm very interested in like rappers, MCs, and how they portray positivity. So what message would you give to MCs that want people to hear their music but it's not offensive? Like, how would you get that positive message across? Like, what's the key?
Just be honest about yourself, and whatever you're portraying, just make sure like you reflect on yourself as well. Like, if you're going to make a song, do you know what I mean? Like, just think to yourself, like, if I play this to my son or mum, are they going to like it? Are they going to incorporate it into their lifestyle? Are they going to understand what you're saying? So, just little things like that you just have to look upon, like, in terms of wordplay and, like, lyrics as well as a rapper MC, you've got to understand that, okay, then not everyone's going to understand your lyricism and how you do it. So, you have to kind of dim it down, but also just not think about all about yourself, you gotta think about everyone else, you know what I mean? But just be open-minded in what you do and just like reflect and be positive about it, yeah.
Who would you say inspires you, and who are you feeling now in the grime scene?
In the grime scene or in general?
In general, but let's do grime.
Grime
first.
Yeah. Well, I started music listening to Soul Solitary, my first ever grime album. I got that because I passed my sats in year 6.
21 seconds.
Yeah. And I used the last 10 seconds where it was the instrumental to actually do grime. So yeah, Soul Solitary 21 seconds. And then I was brought up on Dot Rotten, P-Money, Dizzy Rascal, Ludacris as well, I looked up to. So those are the main people I actually looked up to, and Skepta, of course, like, he's just a legend. Like, yeah, I like him.
Who are you feeling now?
In the grime scene.
Or in general, in the music in general.
Music in general? I like Mary J. Blige a lot.
Okay.
I like her a lot. Like, I like her music and...
She's actually in Birmingham today.
Is she?
Yeah, the NEC.
Yeah, I like her a lot. Like, Mary J. Blige, like, I just like how she does her music. Yeah. And Beyonce. And what's her name now? She's a slow jam singer. I think her name's Tink. Is it Tink?
Tink? Rapper?
Is that a rapper? Tink?
That's on the Timberland's label.
Yeah, Tink. Okay. Yeah, I like Tink.
A lot of females there. I mean, yeah, a lot of females.
Yeah.
That's actually quite surprising, actually.
Yeah, like, I do listen to grime, don't get me wrong, but I like to listen to more subtle, like, inspirational music. Like, those guys are like a lot. Yeah, definitely. They're up there. I like them.
Okay, and what makes you smile? What inspires you? What makes you happy, like, in the mornings?
Just being able to wake up. I know it sounds so cheesy, but it's the honest truth. Like, just to be able to wake up, like, I just like life in general. Like, before I used to have a bit of a downer, do you know what I mean? But as long as you wake up and you can smile and you can do what you gotta do and can walk, like, keep smiling. Like, even if you're vexed, just smile, man. Like, you can't be vexed all day. Something's gonna make you smile sooner or later, you know what I mean? Somebody just start smile from the start. But, yeah, man, just wake up.
And where would you see the music? Like, what's going to be your next role? What are you going to do in the next year or 2 years or so? Is music like a serious thing for you, like, where you're going to make a career out of it, or is it just a hobby, part time?
That's a hard question, because I've been thinking about this for months. Like, when I first started music, I was 100% into music, you know what I mean? Like, I was all about music. But then, like, what else am I going to fall on if music doesn't get me to where I need to be, you know what I mean? That's why, like, now, because I haven't, like, released enough music, because I've been creating another foundation where, in case music doesn't actually get me to the top, I still have a good foundation, you know what I mean? But if music was to, like, get me to where I want to be, like, I wouldn't complain, you know what I mean? Like, what I have now, I'm a structure, I'm a blueprint of how I want my music to go. Hopefully it does push me where I need to be. Like, as I said, like, there's a DVD coming out in September, Prize Fighter Live, which I'm on. There's going to be a few songs also that'll be out in September, which I'm going to be on as well. The visual I have as well on P110, One Take, that should be out soon. I don't know when.
Okay.
But there is a lot going on. It's just structuring it and trying to get the right formula. Like, I'm still trying to get the right formula, do you know what I mean? Get out there. Like, that's why I've been so quiet, but it's coming. It is coming.
How beneficial is our freestyles? Like, what's the importance of a freestyle?
Well, in my opinion, like, they are beneficial, but you can't rely on them 100%. You know what I mean? Like, a freestyle, to me, in my opinion, is just to keep the buzz going. You know what I mean? Like, if I put out a freestyle today, like, I can't keep on putting that freestyle for the rest of my life, you know what I mean? Like, people want to see some structure, they want to see choruses, hooks, a bit of singing, they want to see something versatile. Like, a freestyle is just to keep the ball rolling, like, until you have something to push out there, like an EP or an album or something like that, you know what I mean? But in the meantime, whilst you're quiet, working in the studio, whipping up your little formula, there's a freestyle to keep the fans and, like, you know, the viewers listening. But yeah, it is important, but you shouldn't rely on it 100%.
Can you give us a freestyle? A little wordplay? Just a little tiny bit of a wordplay? Come on.
Okay.
Give us something from where?
Work hard, play hard.
Just a little bit.
Gotta stay focused, gotta stay strong. Put in the work now, can't act long. I know now where I wanna be. I want it by the top with the play in my song. Cheering louder, saying my name. I gotta hang tight like I'm wearing a chain. Keep mine right and I gotta stay focused. I'm not in line, I cannot be tame. Mom says walk on my own. Do you mean? Nothing simple, like those movies. When you see me, I walk on my own. Not being rude, I'm just there in my zone. Peace and quiet so I feel at home. Cause that's the place now where I think I'm a dream. When I wake up and I'm living my dream, gotta stay on track, far from the steam.
I've got to say, like, be that, like, me personally, I think you are like one of my favorite MCs.
Really?
Yeah, because I don't, because the reason why I like you, and it's not even just being biased, because your wordplay is different. It's very unique. And like, I've heard like, obviously I've heard a lot of MCs and a lot of local Birmingham MCs, and you know, I don't, it's really hard to identify the talent, like the key, the message that I want to hear. Whereas you now, like, I've watched you grow and grow and grow.
Yeah.
And I personally think that you need to just like, just push yourself out there, like just keep going and just keep what you're doing.
You know, it's hard though, because
it's hard.
As an artist, as you said, like, yeah. Artist, now, my lyricism and that is different to others.
Yeah.
That's because I'm not from that kind of scene, you know what I mean? Like, they're in that kind of like, you know, that lifestyle where it's been hard for them in other areas. That's where they talk about certain things that I don't talk about, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
I can't talk about busing guns or...
Do you find it boring though? Like, when you just hear like MC just talking about their local, like, down the shop and their local neighborhoods, don't you just find it depressing?
It is depressing.
Like,
don't get me wrong, I like grime, I like that hardcore, like, fast tempo, you know what I mean? But in a sense, like, there's always so much to listen to.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, don't get me wrong, I'm not faulting their talent and what they say, you know what I mean? That's them, that's what they do, you know what I mean? Like, I'm not in that area, you know what I mean? Like, Klaus, now you've heard me, like, when I do my lyrics, I don't spit about no gun crime, no shooting, no running up on people, no selling drugs, like, cause I don't do that, like,
yeah.
I'm not that type of person, you know what I mean? Like, I have a normal lifestyle, you know. Everyone has their hard times, obviously, so I incorporate it that way, but I've got nothing to prove, you know what I mean? So I just keep it simple, but from what everyone gives me, like, in terms of feedback, it seems to work. I just need to put that extra kick, you know what I mean? So
definitely.
Yeah, man.
Definitely. And can you just, like, give me a little...
You played?
It's not a freestyle. I was going to say, could you give me a little jingle?
Oh,
a
jingle?
Yeah, like, you know, inspire myself.
Okay then. Myself, Feed At You, alongside the wonderful Vanessa, Inspire My Smile. She makes me smile because I've been smiling for the past how long, 15 minutes? But Inspire My Smile, Vanessa, one of a kind. Murder.